everyone, we have with us Mr. Sri S. Sivamthan. He has given a presentation regarding the role of international funding agencies in supporting the cost-effective, pollution-free and sustainable metro rail system. Hello, sir. What insights do you have to share with our viewers regarding your presentation?
See, basically my presentation was about having multilateral funding, how it will ensure that the project will be completed in time, and what kind of comfort it's going to give to the contractors. Because wherever the external funding is there, the contractors get confidence that yes, whatever the work we are going to get, if we do the work, we will get the payment in time. One is that. Another is financial closure is very important for any big infrastructure project. Without financial closure, no project can take up. So that will ensure that project will be completed and made available to the public within the time given by the government.
So far as the international funding agencies are concerned, can you share some insights into how does the autonomy of that particular project remains with the organization itself, although there's an involvement of, let's say, an international funding agency? How that particular autonomy remains with that organization itself?
Very good question. See, it is funding. Whatever the loan we are taking, it's the funding. It's one type of financing. But the effective management, effective control lies with the SPV only. The loan which we are taking is not a tied loan. It is a commercial loan. We can source the contractor from any country, not necessarily from the country which is giving the loan. If we are taking loan from JICA, it is not necessary that we have to take the contractor from Japan. We can source from any country, including India. So that freedom is with us. Only the thing is that we have to finalize the tender contract based on their guidelines. That's all. Their guidelines says we have to follow ICB. We have to give free contract procedure should be transparent. If you follow that, there is no conditions, nothing from the funding agency. Ultimately, the effective control management lies with the SPV, that is Bangalore or Delhi or Chennai Metro.
How has your experience been so far here at InnoMetro 4th edition?
Yes, I'm really very delighted and happy to be part of this InnoMetro annual conference. I have been invited every year. Thank you for that. And year after year, the InnoMetro activities are increasing. The level, the kind of shops and all put up here is increasing. I think the space is getting constrained, rather people who are coming and participating are more and more increasing. So really it is bringing new vendors, new companies, new technology to showcase in front of other metro users, RRTS, Indian Railways. It's good to the country.
Since a major chunk, or let's say a considerable chunk of the industry lies here under one roof, what message do you have for the people?
I can think of InnoTrans happens once in 2 years in Germany. Here we have named it as InnoMetro. I think going forward, this will, because the kind of market in India available to multinational companies, this InnoMetro annual conference can go beyond InnoTrans to that level or beyond that. This is what my thinking, this is what my understanding, this is what my expectation.
Thank you, Mr., for your kind words.